Learning how to love and do it is my highest purpose in life.
Hello, lovely people. I'm Michał Kaligrix from Tantra Movement, for those who don't know me. So I will continue the Loving Better course. Today I will speak about the choice between complaining and appreciating. I would say life is down to this choice between complaining and appreciating, and that's up to this. It is how you experience the life. In other words, you can see the cup is half empty or half full. And yes, I will ask you a question. Did you ever experience living through some experience in your life with someone else, and you did notice once the difference between their experience and your experience? Even you went through the same things, the experience sometimes could be completely opposite. Like yes, one person can see things very positively and like, hey, yes, we're gonna learn from mistakes, it's gonna make us further, and stay optimistic and looking forward, and see that, okay, it's not like see the bright sides of the life. And enjoying experience in general, not regretting that situation, but really appreciating that it happened in their lives. But the same situation for someone else can be like a hell. So it's all up to our life experience, or up to our conditionings, and so and so and so. So that's why I feel it's best to learn to grow into appreciating life. One of the biggest power in spirituality, in life, it's gratitude in advance. When you're thankful to things in advance, when you are appreciating them, then it's more probable than they would be very beautiful for you. But if you are complaining about them from the beginning, then it's more probable that they would be as a not nice experience. I would like to show you the example from my life. It happened that I used to live in different societies, different countries, different people around, different groups of the society, and I noticed that yes, sometimes poor people can be more happy than those who have everything, and yes, still want to have more and never satisfied. So yes, being on the top of your career, or being famous, or being spiritual, enlightened, or whatever top you are, maybe most beautiful and so, it doesn't mean that you're gonna be happy. It's, I would say, it's from a beautiful movie, Bliss. It's yeah, you can work on how on this, how your body look like, but it's easy to work on how you are content with the look like, what it is, and how to adjust to everything. You can work on how many things you gather in life, how big status you have in life, how affected you are in your community, and so. But if you are not working on contentment in this moment, here and now, then you can be on the top. And I know many people on the tops of many tops, maybe not even one top, but a few tops. And yes, they were still unhappy. So this is not guarantee for you to, yes, be happy and content. You work on being content right now. So that's what I would like to encourage you. And yes, for example, I used to live in one country where yes, people like to complain about the weather, about everything. If it's sunny, they complain that it's too hot. If it's rainy, they complain that it's too rainy and never good enough. Yeah, this country is very rich, very, very rich. And yes, people like the happiness level of the people, not the best. Yes, now I live in Thailand. People sometimes they do not have teeth. They live in the kind of slums house, iron. They work very hard in life. It's like how many things, how rich you are, it doesn't mean equals how happy you are. So don't go into that trap. Learn rather how to be content with this what you have rather than with complaining about this what you don't have. So appreciate this what you have than rather than complain about the things what you still do not have. Because if you are in the lack mentality, you will stay in the lack mentality. You will never fulfill your greed and this yes, that there is not enough for you, that you are good, not good enough or something like this. You have to step out from this cycle. And yes, we know it all from movies like Secret and about like the law of attractions and so. And yes, I would like to give a big credit to the affirmations work, what gives us a big power and gives us the impulse and also awareness how the things work and so. But yes, I would like to make you aware that this is just part of the solution and it's not always work, you know. Like I know some people went into the trap that yes, they start to talk a lot of affirmations, but it's like empty spirituality, nothing behind and so on and so on. The person who through all their life experienced poverty and was very often hungry and had the experienced this lack and so on and so on. Suddenly it would start to say, okay, I'm rich, and start behaving like rich. Yes, there are deep things in the subconscious mind. And yes, consciously he chose to be rich and he even behaved like a rich. But if the subconscious is still operating on the repetition of conditionings that he will spend all his money and again will end up in the same situation. So yes, also the same thing, like if the person were, for example, sexually abused, you cannot, like if the damage happened on the body level, you cannot say to yourself, oh, now I will trust the man, now I will trust the sexuality and it will disappear. It has to be healed on the body level. And that's why Tantra is very beautiful, because Tantra works with all aspects, with all the tools. It doesn't only limit to one chakra to work on the one way, but it works mentally, but also on the body level, on the heart level, on the emotional level, through the release of the emotions. So yes, I invite you to go further into this and yes, learn how to be find the happiness here and now instead of complaining and staying in the unhappiness here and now. Meditate on it and find the solution and create the solutions. And if you need any professional help on any aspects, like for example healing your sexuality or reprogramming your mind, the exact solution, or use all of them, because sometimes they are much more powerful when they're combined together. And that's what also Tantra does. It works on many levels, on many dimensions, and it works in all possible ways. That's what we're working here with in Tantra Movement. Thank you very much for your attention.